Hey guys, Ryan here at Signature Edits, and today I'm going to save you a ton of time in Photoshop by showing you how to change the color of pretty much anything inside of Lightroom. Let's get into it. All right, so when I found this technique out, it blew my flipping mind. Why? Because it saves so much time and it just unlocks a feature I had no idea existed. So let me show you what I'm talking about. To do this, we are going to go to our adjustment brush layer and we're going to use the auto mask feature in Lightroom. Okay, so if you need a deeper tutorial of how the auto mask brush works, just go and watch our tutorial. I've got a little link in the description here. And what we're going to do is just click here on the bus. And Lightroom is automatically going to mask this. I'm going to make sure my flow is all the way up. Auto mask is enabled. I've zoomed out so that I can cover the entire image with my brush, and I click once on that bus. That's basically going to sample the color wherever I click, and everything within that color kind of color brightness range, Lightroom is automatically going to mask out. So now you can see, I've pressed O so I can see my mask, that my entire bus has been masked out. I could go in here and see there's some shadows right here in the inside of the bus that aren't quite captured. We could just clean that up really quick. Zoom in, go in there and paint. Right, I could do that. But for the sake of this tutorial, we're just going to very generally mask out this bus, okay? So we've got that masked. Now, to change the color of anything in Lightroom, here's all you have to do. I'm going to take my saturation all the way down. Press O again so I can see what I'm doing. Now the bus is white. So if you want to turn something white or gray in Lightroom, there's your answer, all right? Now let's look at the color version. All I'm going to do is take my saturation all the way down. Then I'm going to go down where it says color, and I'm going to hit this little X-y box. Great. Now I'm going to use my little dropper tool to just decide what color I want to fill that mask in with. Mind-blowing, right? So now I can change this bus to be whatever color I want. So let's say I'm going for a lime green bus. That looks pretty good. If I want to actually get that color more saturated, more pronounced, all I have to do is right-click on my mask and go duplicate. And every time I duplicate it, Lightroom is going to stack another layer of that mask on top. And I'm going to get greener and greener and greener until you can't even take it. It looks like lime green radioactive Kool-Aid. Okay, so that is how you do it with this particular image. Let me show you another one. So this one is another creative effect that we can use this for. We're going to zoom out, use the same technique with my auto mask feature. Turn that on, flow up, make my brush nice and big, and click once in the sky. Here's how you do a sky replacement. Well, replacement, a sky edit, add some effects really quick in Lightroom. I'm pressing O so I can see my mask. Great. Looks like I got everything. And I can actually just hold Alt. That'll toggle my eraser. And just erase the mask on his shirt. And down here in the ocean, I just want to replace the sky for now. If I want to make that mask a little cleaner, I can turn my feather up on the eraser and my flow down. And just sort of gradually decrease that transition here. Great. Now you get the gist of it. We've got that masked out. I'm going to press O again so I can see what I'm doing here. Take my brush and reset it, because for some reason the effects are not correct. I'm going to take my saturation down. Click here on the colors. And let's say I want to make this guy red. Well, we can do that now. All I have to do is click. Perfect, just like that. And if I want to exaggerate that effect, I can just duplicate. Now you can see it's not absolutely perfect in every way because we've still got, you know, these waves kind of coming up and looking a little bit unnatural, but I mean, it's a red sky. What do you expect? It's going to be a little unnatural. We can play with that by either using our eraser and just sort of making that transition a little bit more gradual. Oops, that's the wrong. That's my eraser. There we go. Do that, maybe take our brush, and we can take our flow down, auto mask off. And if we wanted, we could just brush around here on these hard edges and just soften them up. So there are ways, and you can tinker from there, but you can see how fast it is to go in, change the color of pretty much anything. Let me show you another shot. So let's say we want to get some really creative effects with the forest. Can we do it with this technique? Well, there are some limitations inside of Lightroom because it really only works for images where you've got one specific area of brightness or color. If you've got a very complicated mask, it's going to look less natural. So let me show you what I mean. Let's zoom out, grab this, I've got my flow up, click once, and let's say I want to change the color of the water. So I click the water. It's doing an okay job. We've got most of the water, but you can see it's also showing up in the trees here. So if I try and do the same technique, take my saturation down. Let's say I want it to look like lava in here. Let's grab an orange. It looks okay, but we're also going to run into some issues with the trees here because they're a similar shade. So I would either have to go through and erase those like this, Or I just have to embrace it and say, okay, well, there are some limitations here. And I still, I mean, let's be honest, this is pretty flipping amazing to be able to do inside of Lightroom in about 2 seconds. And then I could do this again if I wanted. Let's make another adjustment brush layer, new one, auto mask out this. I don't have to zoom out because I can cover the whole area with my brush. Great, we'll just click in there so I've masked out the water. Saturation down, and color, let's grab maybe a purple here. So you can see because this area is white, it's actually not adding color. It was all blown out. So I just have to take my exposure down to fix that. And we're just going to duplicate a couple of times. And now we have the world's weirdest looking nature photo. So there you go. If you want to edit photos to look entirely unnatural, you can do that with this trick. Let's move on. One more quick shot just to show you how cool this is. I can grab the sky really fast. Zoom out. Got my flow up, auto mask on. Click, click. Great. Just keep clicking on areas that haven't been masked if it's not working for you the first time. And then I'm just going to erase down here because I don't need any of this section to be affected. Great. Take my saturation down. Press O again so I can see what I'm doing. And let's make the sky green. Or let's say that I've blown out the sky. I can't get it back inside of this edit. I can actually just add blue to the sky if I want. So that is a super easy, quick technique that you can use to edit your images inside of Lightroom and make them look awesome. So that's how you can get super crazy, unnatural looking blue skies, or go a little bit more moderate and make some great effects quickly, simply, and easily. Let's change the color of his shirt here. So we're going to do the same thing, new adjustment brush. Da-da-da, click there. Just keep clicking until we've brushed out his whole shirt. And you can see it's picking up the desert because it's not a very specific color we're working with. So let's just delete that. Try once more. We're going to zoom out. Turn my feather down. And click again on his shirt. And you can see there are limitations to this technique in that you're only going to be able to work with specific color ranges. So if he was wearing a red shirt, it would be super easy to actually mask out that shirt, or a bright green shirt. But since it's white, Lightroom's going to have a tough time masking out just that shirt. It's going to want to mask out all the other similar tones in that area. So we're a little more limited. I can't take his shirt and turn it, you know, completely green because it'll affect other areas of this image. So there are some limitations, but honestly, what an amazing technique when it comes to really quickly and easily adding effects or just changing colors in Lightroom. You don't have to go crazy and make it look unnatural, but really quickly you can go from having a blue bus to a nice pastel green bus, and nobody would ever know that this wasn't the original color of the bus if you're taking your time and getting a nice mask. So I hope this tutorial was helpful for you. If it was, please smash that like button. Don't forget to subscribe and come back for more great content. And hey, if you're looking for some awesome Lightroom presets, we have a few packs out now. You can download some free sample packs in the links below, and I'll set you up. All right, take care. See you in the next one.